All right. This is the beginning of my game. It's covered in vines. There's a piggy coming in the window. And there's a chicken stack over here. Anyway, we start by taking this. Here we go. Oh my goodness. Sorry about that. I walked in fire. Okay. So here we are talking to this wolf. Wolf whispers to you. How can I help you, simpleton? Let's go with the detailed answer. I woke up in a dark, smelly place and I saw vines and things everywhere. I got up and looked around and saw chests. I opened them to find armor and weapons. After that, I left the place and came here because something smelled good. Now I am asking you what to do. Wolf whispers to you. Well, I have a problem with people wanting my food, but I would be glad to point you in the right direction. Great. Which way is it then? Wolf whispers to you. You must take the map that is from the chest behind me and follow it until you reach the green mark. I wish you good luck on your journey. Alright, so this is his map. Alright, so we are the little white mark, and we are trying to get to the green. Oh no. Watch where we're going with these maps. Alright, here we are. There's this map right on the wall there. Follow the race path down to the water for the first part of the game. Jump around to make it across. That's cool. Alright. Let's come down here. Ones. You actually have to sprint across the lily pad so that you have more momentum. But as for the smaller jump, you don't actually have to do, you just have to walk. And here's a hint, you can actually press shift to make you slower, and you can't fall off the block. I'm pressing shift now. I'll just show you. See, I'm squatting there. And I walk forward, and I cannot go any further because I have such a, it's kind of a cool thing, especially when you're on high spots and you don't want to fall off. Alright, so now I have some water, but the water's already there because it's all. But as you jump, you can right-click to place the water on blocks, and then you jump into the water and put it into the block. But when you're jumping down, you can jump down into water, you actually sink a really far, so it goes back to work, so you jump off a lot. Alright, so I made it across eventually. I'm just gonna eat apple.
There we go.
Alright. So, place water somewhere so you, if you fall, you can get back up. Alright? So, alright. So, long boat. I'm guessing we want some of these. We'll just put multi map in there and we'll get in the boat. Don't go too fast or you'll crash and have to start again. Enjoy the sunset ride into the first level. Once you get inside, please drink your potion. Drink your potions every time you start to lose bubbles. Drink one of each to make sure you can see and breathe. Alright. The boat here. And you press shift to dismount. So here we go. We're going to drink a night vision potion and a water breathing potion. There we go. And now we're going down. And because we drank the night vision potion, we can now see under the water, so it'll be pitch black. And the water being good, of course, that makes it so you can breathe from the water and you don't lose the bubbles above the food. So, let's sink in here and go on. As you can see, it took a really long time to do this actually because there's lava everywhere. So, let's come here and open this. What was the name of the group of people in the myth? Was it Hiermenska, Mentrathist, or Squamish? I guess we'll have to see. Alright, so I chose the right one, and this just puts you so that if you die, you spawn here again. What is the son of... Wait, what? Sorry, this is supposed to say, what is the sun called in this myth? Is it Big Fire, Big Star, Snuckum, Sun, just didn't change at all, Shinkat, Hot Ball of Fire, Menski, or just Fire? Well, if you step on the wrong one, you're basically gonna die because you're spawning on the wrong things. I'll just show you once. And there you go. And he is over. Yep, he's just went and spawned another one. Now we've got two. Now we've got three. So as you can see, as you wait longer to kill them, they keep spawning more because the pressure plate's on. So it's there we go. Alright, we made it through. Isn't that pretty? Alright. What did Snuckum, that's the name of the sun, transform into in the myth? Was it a bear, a raccoon, or an eagle? When the brothers transformed the other brother, what did he change into? Was it a whale, a salmon again, a crab, or algae? So the first time they changed into the salmon, we're talking about the second time here. So it was, there we go. That's what's going on, it's just as apples. All right. What was the tribe careful to do with the bones of the salmon that they ate? Smash and bury them beside the water, throw them in the water, bury them, use them for crafting. Here we are. So this is the spirits of the native people of this land. Congratulations, you have made it halfway. Now you must jump off of this Okay, sorry guys. I don't know what happened, but I teleported somewhere. Alright, let's try this again. So, you just have to jump off the side to test your bravery. Jump off the side, and you will land. But where you will land, you will have to find out for yourself. So, there's a sign here that says, I would suggest this side. Okay, we land in spiderwebs. So, we live. I'm gonna eat another apple. Here we go, slowly floating down. There we go. Almost there. There. So, just gonna do this. When Sniffin was captured by the brothers, he asked for blank in exchange for the area of salmon. Salmon, when you find them, the recipe for chocolate chip cookies, his freedom, the leprechaun's pot of gold. When they had eaten the four salmon and thrown them away, when they had eaten the four salmon and thrown away the bones and gotten the kids back, what was missing? Half a face, hand, toe, the brain. So we got vines, so we could climb up here. And now I'm going to come all the way up here. Sorry, I had a bit of a problem there. So now we have this map. And again, it shows us where to go over there. And we also got all this, which is basically so we can, of course, get there fast if it decides it wants to go fast. Ooh. Ooh, this is awesome. Alright. So we just gotta wait as hard as it can, then press down on it. There we go, saddle and armor, and here we go. Alright, let's go around the tree. Here we go. Go. Spider on the way. Alright, so here we are. Right over here is where it says to go. Alright, here. It says, please dismount before stepping. Alright, we'll leave the horse here. Alright, here we are. There's more apples in here, so we don't really need a lot. Alright, four kinds of salmon that visit the peoples. Coho, sockeye, dog salmon, humpback, sockeye, tuna, chum, humpback, chum, sardine, sockeye, halibut, sockeye, chum, cat salmon, humpback. Alright, here we are at the finish. All done, and this cool little thing took me forever to build. Shoots out fireworks because it's finished. And it's super cool. Alright, so on to level 2. Oh, here's some guys that are here to help me. Alright. What do the Inuit of the Arctic eat? Mostly meat. Some plants. Plants with little meat. Lots of bone. Alright. How do they keep warm in all the cold weather? Fire lamp, warm clothing, and shelter. Eat fat fur. Big fire and warm clothing. Alright, here we are. The next question. As you can see, I built the illusions a bit. It took a long time. Alright. Here we go. How do they travel in summer versus winter? Sleds in winter, walk in summer. Sleds in summer, walk in winter. Sleds all the time, walk all the time. I have to bug you something here. Alright. Here we go. Next question. How do they eat their food? Alright, I had fun building this one because I actually made it look like it is a butcher shop because I thought that would fit with the question. So we actually have pigs, cows, and a bunch of chickens. I thought that was pretty funny. And it's just a book of food. But we'll leave that because we have animals. Alright. So, how did they eat their food? Cooked or raw? That's funny because they eat it raw, but we got cooked. Alright. How do they freeze their food to keep it good? Put it outside. Make a little box out of snow and ice. Put it in there. Bury it in snow. Enter. Alright, we'll go in here then. When they see trees, they are huge and tall. Small like a shrub or normal. Go. What are Inukshuks used for? Marking where they've been, herding caribou, fun figures for the kids to play with. They didn't build them. Alright, here's this one. Why did the Arctic peoples all just appear in the 1900s? They tried to start swimming. They all froze. They didn't. They all got shot. Alright, here's the end of level 2. And as you can see, this took me a really long time. Alright, step on the first plate, this one's on you, and they die. Because they've been taunting the whole time. You can just keep spawning and killing them. You don't even have to do anything but step on the first plate. I thought that was pretty awesome. Alright. So, here we go. Over here. Alright, let's just do this. Alright, here we go. To the end of the game, Funhouse. Alright, so as you can see, we got some gold. Okay. So, it says, one gold for a cake. Press Q to pay for gold. You pay with gold. Alright. So, one gold for a cake. Okay, so press Q. It should go in, but no, it's bouncing in front of my face. I had to fix this, but now it should work. If it doesn't, then I still have it out here. There we go. So, would you like a cake? Click on the yes. I really do. I'm hungry. So, now we've got a cake. This actually took a little while to set up, but it's really super cool. So, there we go. Cake there, and then you can eat it when you're hungry. Alright, so there's more stuff over here. Basically more stuff like the vine thing. Alright. Click on the item to buy it. Yummy cookie. There we go. So now I've got a yummy cookie. And over here, it's kind of the same thing, but you just have to... I actually made the words yellow on this one, which is kind of fun. There we go. So, I've got that. So here's this little treehouse. But anyway, I built this and I thought it would be kind of cool because it kind of went with the theme of like the native peoples. So, you can use that if you want. Yeah. And so basically, there's actually this really cool glitch that I actually accidentally found when I was goofing around. And you can actually get on here. You can get on here. This is where most people would first shift, but I'm not even gonna bother. Alright, so you can actually get on here and get onto these trees which is really funny. And then you can jump off the tree onto the roof. So I'm now on the roof of the store, which I thought was really funny. So there we go. That's the end of the game, and I like eating cake.